It's been a wild women's college basketball season so far, and we're only a few days into December. We had tons of upsets outside of the Power 10, including LSU taking down number 14 Iowa State for head coach Kim Mulkey to get her first ranked win in her new chapter with the Tigers. But let's take a look at how my Power 10 rankings in week four shakes out. My top four remain the same. South Carolina owns the throne in my Power 10. The Gamecocks improved to a 9-0 record after taking down North Carolina A&T and Kansas State. The Gamecocks already have three ranked wins under its belt, but their next test will be on Sunday, December 12th, when they face Maryland in the Women's Jimmy V Classic. That matchup will be must-see TV. UConn comes in at number two. The Huskies defeated Seton Hall, plus its second-ranked win over number 24 Notre Dame, 73-54. It's been a great week in the win column, but unfortunately, injuries have plagued the Huskies' depth. The number one overall recruit, AZ Fudd, is sitting out for a while due to a foot injury, and Paige Beckers went down towards the end of the game with possibly a serious injury. No update on the National Player of the Year's status, but will be evaluated soon. How about NC State getting its revenge to remain in my top three? NC State took down Indiana after the Hoosiers gave them an early exit in last year's Sweet 16. Diamond Johnson stepped up tremendously as the spark the Wolfpack needed on both ends to come out victorious, scoring 19 points. Kayla Jones was the unsung hero with all 17 of her points scored in the second half. The Wolfpack cruised past Elon to finish week four strong. Stanford stays at number four in my rankings, but the Cardinal did not play this week due to a two-week exam break. Now, let's get into some movement. Maryland moves up one to round out my top five. The Terps return two of its key pieces, Katie Benson and Faith Misonis, after facing illnesses during back-to-back losses in the Bahamas. Maryland went up against a gritty Miami and Rutgers team, but came out victorious in both matchups, paced by Angel Reese, who currently leads Maryland in scoring in place of Ashley Owusu. Indiana falls down one to my number six spot. The Hoosiers only played one game this week and got a taste of their own medicine with NC State getting its Sweet 16 revenge. Mackenzie Holmes was incredible for the Hoosiers on both ends, but she needed help. The Hoosiers struggled to get in an offensive rhythm, but they will look to bounce back against Big Ten foes when they start conference play this week. Iowa falling two spots in my Power 10 allowed Louisville to slide up to my number seven ranking. It helps when you get a statement win over then number 12 Michigan. These two teams are Sweet 16 contenders, and the number two scoring defense in the nation blew past Michigan 70-48 by controlling the boards and scoring 38 points off of turnovers. Baylor moves up to number eight. The Bears blew past Morehead State. However, Missouri presented a scare for the Bears, coming close to knocking off Baylor. In the second half, Baylor missed 10 crucial free throws, but thankfully, Baylor survived in the Big 12 SEC Challenge with a 70-68 victory. As I mentioned, Iowa comes in at number nine after Duke upset the Hawkeyes. It's been an early roller coaster ride for Iowa, who came off of a three-game cancellation due to positive COVID-19 tests within the program. But the Hawkeyes were able to bounce back by defeating Michigan State to open up Big Ten play, giving head coach Lisa Bluter her 800th win. Caitlin Clark was back in full rhythm against the Spartans, recording her second triple-double of the season, and Iowa has only played six games. And to wrap up my Power 10, Arizona stays at number 10. The Wildcats are currently 7-0 so far, but they did not play this week due to a COVID-19 outbreak with UC Riverside's program. That's all for my week four rankings. Tune in every week on NCAA.com and NCAA Women's Basketball Social for more.